Hello all, welcome back. In this session, we will discuss the namespace concept in Python. What is namespace and why do we need it? This is the first thing that we need to understand. This is similar to the namespaces that we have seen in the C++ programming, whatever we have discussed earlier, and I have a separate playlist for it. But let me tell you quickly what is namespace with a brief note. I may have a person by name, say Johnson at home 1. I may have a person by the same name, Johnson, at home 2. Are they same? No, they are different. They belong to two different houses. So from house 1, if Johnson is called, that should call only the Johnson from house 1, and it should not call the Johnson at house 2. So for this, we need to have namespace in the programming. What do you mean by that? I have a variable or a content that is available in function 1 or module 1. And the same named variable or content is available in module 2. If I want to call the content from module 1, it should be called specifically and it should not be ambiguous in calling the second one, which also has the same name. The content should be called based on where it is living and not based on just the name. This is called namespace. This is exactly what is done in C++, and we used a thing called as namespace there. We used that keyword there, but here in Python, it is very, very simple and there is no problem with respect to using any keyword and all. It is very easy for you. So we'll see an example right away, which will help you understanding this concept in a much more easier way. And as usual, I'm going to go with the code. Let's see the code with a very simple example. You can see that here I have got a code by name namespace underscore one dot py. This is the name of the file. So in this file, I have a function by name function underscore demo of I, return I plus 2. Now, I have another file by name namespace underscore 2.py, where I have the same function name and I have got a different content here, return I minus 2. So please understand, the function name alone remains similar. Rest of the things inside the function can be different. Even the argument that I pass is the same. So please remember, the content, the work that the function is gonna do is different, but the name of the function, the argument that I'm going to pass, everything remains the same, but they are in two different files. Now what am I going to do is, I'm going to use the import. I have already taught you the import content and it is very easy to understand. If you do not know that, please go back and refer that videos where I have taught you how to import modules. So I'm now importing import namespace 1. This module has been imported. Then I'm importing import namespace 2. Now I'm going to call the function underscore demo from the first file, from the first module. So what do I do? RES equal to namespace underscore 1 dot function underscore demo. This tells that the function underscore demo, which is available in namespace 1, should alone be called and the result should be returned. Now the next line, I call the namespace underscore 2 dot function demo, which says that this should call the function underscore demo, which is available in the file 2, which is nothing but this file. And the first time it was this file, and this namespace, the way we call it here, is going to help us out in calling it appropriately. Let's see how the result comes. It is 3 and 1, and that is most appropriate. Why 3 and 1? I pass 1 here. So when I go to the first function, 1 plus 2 will be returned, that is 3. Now come back. I plus 3 here. So what do we do here? I do I minus 2. So 3 minus 2 is 1. So what is the output? I must have got 3 and 1. That is it. The namespace is simple. I hope you guys understood. And if you have not understood that, you may have to listen to it once more and let me know in case of any queries. Now we are going to see the next very important concept and a very important interview question as well. That is local, global and built-in namespace. The terms are very clear and thanks to all Python creators who did it very nice. Built-in are all already pre-written and they are very well defined and they are available by default. So don't worry about it. Global namespace is nothing but which is made available by default for the whole file. The complete file has got the access to it. Local namespace is nothing but it is available for the usage only within the function. That is it. We'll see an example as usual. That rocks, right? Yeah, we'll go for the example. Now see that definition function demo x. This is a global namespace. This function is available to be accessed from this file at any point. Now print. Here you go with the global namespace x. number equal to 1, number equal to number plus 1, something. Now see this, this number equal to 1 is nothing but the local namespace. This number cannot be accessed from outside, which means this number is restricted within this function. Now what do? I just add 1 to it and I print it. Now array underscore number equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The built-in namespace is now coming into picture. Sum, this is called built-in namespace. Sum of array number. So it automatically pulls in the built-in functions and that's referred as built-in namespace. Now what do? I call the function demo 3 plus 3 into 2. So it is 3 into 2 plus 3 first. So 6 plus 9, 3, 9 is sent here. And global namespace 9 should be printed. Now I have a local namespace number here and I add 1 to it. The local namespace concept is proven and I have an array of numbers here, which is nothing but the list here. And then I get it also arranged in proper order. Do we have the output? Yes, we do have. The built-in namespace is 15. Here you go. The global namespace is 9. The local namespace is 2. It is all properly coming as output. And that is it. In this session, we have seen the namespace concept and the learning shall grow in the next session as well. I hope the contents that I'm giving are clear and precise. If you have any queries, suggestions, inputs, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to answer your queries. And most important point, if you like the content, please subscribe. And I would look forward to talk to you in the next session. Thank you.